What's good? What's going down? 215 Raider Nation back again, making an update video on my latest pickups. Previously on the Nation's Table, I showed you Wade Barrett, Daniel Bryan, Justin Gabriel, Heath Slater, Skip Sheffield, and Darren Young. But I didn't show you these two guys, David Otunga and Michael Tarver. Just picked them up today. That makes us official. I have the whole Nexus 8 first cast season 1 of all the guys. I'm kind of pretty excited about that. I'm really feeling these figures. I know a lot of people really can't really stand basic figures, but it's just the fact that, I don't know, basic figures is kind of cool to me. I know I was talking to Rebel about this over YouTube. It's just about having the thrill of having new characters. And I'm happy to say I have the newest of the young guns in the World Wrestling Entertainment, which not everybody is going to make it out this group. We already know this guy already been released out of WWE, but still a cool figure to have. So, me showing this figure, let me talk a little bit about Mr. Michael Tarver. Michael Tarver, very good head scan. This looked just like him when he first left. Only thing I wish he had was the mask. But he got his face sculpting down to a T with his tattoos. Tattoos like some Chinese letters on his both his shoulder blades. Then he got this biohazard type tattoo on the side right there. Some other, like a Transformer tattoo. I don't know what kind of tattoo that is. And we got the Nexus armband right there. Another type of hazard signs. Another Chinese letters. Turn it on the back. He got this design, which spell out a T, which I would prefer they just had the straight T on there besides the design. Standard knee pads, black. He got black boots with like white trim on his boots. Also have some white wrist tape. Pretty standard basic figure. Michael Tarver, they cut him from WWE because some backstage politics and stuff. Really didn't have nothing to use him for. They kicked him out of Nexus like really early. Got destroyed by John Cena, which rumor has it that he's not really a big fan of John Cena. And John Cena really not a big fan of this guy. It could be one of the reasons why he's unemployed. I think he had a cool gimmick. I think he wasn't given really an opportunity of using a gimmick. But I think if he got pushed a bit more, he'd have probably been a good mid-carder. Out of all these guys, I mean, he had one of the coolest gimmicks. I guess like some type of thug or some type of brawler. I mean, his movesets was kind of mediocre, but I mean, we really didn't see that much about the guy. I do like him more than this guy. I can't stand this guy. But I like Skip. Skip's pretty cool, too. I like these four. These guys four is cool. But Michael Tarver is pretty cool. Maybe one day we'll see him back in WWE. Who knows? But I know now he's doing some type of... I think he's like a preacher or something. I don't know what he's doing. I'm sorry, he's doing some type of preaching down somewhere, some city. The last time I heard about him. But pretty cool figure. I'm really feeling it a lot. I'm happy I found the 2-pack of him and this guy, David the A-List Otunga. Pretty cool face sculpting. Got a little mark on there by his eyebrows, but that could be fixed. Got a low haircut. Nexus armband. Got a little tattoo right there on the side, which does he have in real life, like some more Chinese letters. We got this really cool trunks with like, it's like a grayish black with like a olive green colors in it. We've got a skull face right there. Turn on the back. You also got some type of symbol back there. It's supposed to say like in a circle swivel. Pretty decent. Really nice graphic of the tight trunks. Standard black knee pads, standard black boots. None of these people came with stands. I just put stands on there so they won't fall. Really don't have no armbands or wristbands, nothing like that. Dave Antonga, he's pretty standard. I think he's really good on a microphone. He's not really good athletically wise. I mean, he's built, which we all know Vince McMahon like built guys, but I don't think he got a good move set. But he's pretty good on a mic, kind of conceited guy. He played that whole role of him being Jennifer Hudson's lover, boyfriend, fiance, whatever he is, husband to her. So he used that as like a vantage point. But right now he's tag team up with Mike McGillicuddy, which I can't wait for them to make a Mike McGillicuddy figure. I really like Mike McGillicuddy, you know, being a second, third generation superstar. I like to have him part of the new Nexus, hopefully, and make a Mason Ryan as well, and Husky Harris. But, pretty cool figure. I thought actually was going to win NXT at one point, but she didn't win. Wade Barrett won. But I don't see him doing anything big. I mean, I feel like he's going to still be at a mid-card level. I don't think he's going to be like a big-time superstar anytime soon. Got a lot of improvement to do in a ring. But on the mic, I think he's pretty decent. But, So for anyone that's looking for these Nexus figures, I say check out your local Kmart. I mean, not your Kmart. Toys R Us. That's where I found them at. I happened to be on my lunch break, and I went to Toys R Express just to check in. I check in like there every day, and it actually had some new figures in. They had the two packs of these two guys, and they had they still got Elite 8 in there. I don't really want nothing else in Elite 8. I pretty much got everybody except William Regal, and I don't want a Regal figure. I try to stay out of Toys R Us anyway, because Toys R Us is more expensive, especially Toys R Express. I paid more money getting this two-pack than I paid, got the Darren Young and Justin Gabriel from the regular Toys R Us. But I wanted these figures, and I was willing to pay the price for it, because I don't know, they're rare, it's hard to find, which I think any figure these days is very hard to find if you only see it one day at your store and the next day it's sold out. So I had to grab them when I first saw them. Pretty much like I keep saying, I completed my Nexus pack. My next figures I'm thinking about getting, if I come across them, maybe Elite 10 Big Show. That's probably the next figure I actually look for. Besides that, really nothing else. I'm also looking for some Defining Moments. I'm only looking for Defining Moments Undertaker. I'm not really into getting Stone Cold. Probably have to pick like two or three of them Undertakers up for my friends. Also, I'm looking for Legends 5. I'm looking for Rick Martel. I'm looking for Akeem. Wave 6, man. That's like the big wave I've been wanting all the Legends out of them. Legends series, Wave 6. I don't know. They push it back to the back burner because they stopped making Legends. But I know they're supposed to come out with Wave 6 before they even roll this whole rollout of saying no more Legends figures. So I know they already made the figures. They might as well put them out. Hopefully it won't be no type of Maddie exclusive. I like to find these guys in stores eventually. Now, of course, any new TNA have been pretty decent at the moment, but we don't know what TNA doing or whatever. But here we have it. Just want to show you a quick update of the Nexus 8. And thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more videos in the near future. 215 Red Nation saying God bless. Go subscribe. Comment, rate, subscribe, whatever you do, just do it, and I'll get at you again, YouTubers. All right, good night, and peace.